Days. I'm your host, Cliff Russell, and a very special guest, a regular guest, is Keith Owens, the senior editor of the Michigan Chronicle. Good to have you back, sir.
Good to be back.
So much has happened along the Flint water crisis story, along Detroit Public Schools and other things. I'm going to jump right in. Mm-hmm. The latest, maybe greatest revelation so far of the Flint water crisis is the fact that the state was shipping in water to the Michigan office building in Flint in January of last year. At the same time, they were telling the residents, the water's okay, don't worry, relax, you can drink the water. What does that indicate to you, Keith?
Well, it indicates they're lying. You know, I mean, basically, I mean, that if they're saying that their water wasn't bad and the people can go ahead and drink it, but in the meantime, they're sneaking in water in the back door to feed themselves, and that's basically plantation mentality. You know, that's basically saying that, you know, we take care of folks up in the big house, you know, while everybody out in the field, if you fend for yourselves. And I think that's exactly what's happening. I mean, because if they were confident that the water was okay, I mean, it's an obvious story. It's not detail. I mean, it's an obvious story. I mean, if they were confident that the water was clean and the water was fine and to relax, as you say, it was reported, then you wouldn't need to be bringing special water and say, choose which water you want to drink. I mean, that's...
I mean, the state tried to offer a clumsy excuse saying, well, we were just responding to Flint saying there were issues with the water. We're not saying that the water was bad.
Well, then why did they respond in the neighborhoods?
Yes.
You know, if they were responding, that's where they should have responded to. I mean, those are the constituents. You know, if you're going to respond, the first place you respond are in the 100,000 people who live in the neighborhoods, not just the folks who come to work every day around you. Right. So, I mean, that doesn't fly. That doesn't work.
Couple that with some of the statements the governor's made. We were talking before the broadcast about how the governor was responding to a local reporter about the conflict between what the Attorney General Bill Schuette had said, don't drink the water, I wouldn't let my kids bathe in it, you shouldn't either. Right. And the governor saying, yeah, I'd bathe my grandkids in it. And the governor says, well, people have got to make their own decisions. I was flabbergasted. Is that more of a smoking gun, if you will?
Yeah, it's another smoking gun, and it's also, instance, as we were also discussing, I think that he's beginning to crack at the seams. Mm-hmm. I mean, when you start to make a decision, you're talking about children. You know, make your own decisions. I mean, he's just frustrated. He's tired of the questions. He wants to be out of the spotlight. He doesn't handle pressure well. Right. And I think that's what is happening, because the questions are coming at him hard and heavy now. They're coming from the national level. They're coming locally. They're coming from the right. They're coming from the left. And he can't turn around without somebody else coming at him and blaming him, and he doesn't know how to deal with it. And I think at this point, what that really is evidence of is that the pressure is really getting to him.
You know, I'm not sure which is worse either, Keith. The governor saying there were underlings underneath me who made these mistakes and they failed me, but I'm responsible, but they failed me, and I'm going to fix it. Or the governor actually knowing what is going on and scapegoating these people. Which is worse, knowing and lying about it, or not knowing and having this government run amok?
Well, I think it's six in one hand, half dozen in the other. You know, I think the question is, which one was it? And I think, you know, what did he know or did he not know? And I tend to think that he knew more than letting on. I mean, because what is sounding is very much very Nixonian. I mean, in the sense that now, you know, you have your first level of soldiers fall, and people begin falling on their swords. You know, so you're having the, you know, DQ guy was let go. You have other people let go, and that's pretty much how that turns out. I mean, you hope that the first row of folks fall down, that will take care. If it doesn't, then you have the next row of soldiers step up, and they fall on their swords. If that doesn't happen, you know, you keep on trying to keep it from getting to the top level because of the ramifications of that and the culpability. So I think that is what we're seeing. I mean, if in fact that's wrong and he really did not know what was going on, then that in a sense is really bizarre, because I mean, for this is a major cover up essentially that was going on for 3 years. And if you don't know what's going on at that level for, you know, in your departments for 3 years, but you're the one in charge, and you are elected for your business expertise. That's the whole thing. That's what, you know, Republicans love, is that put a businessman in charge. Well, I mean, what does it say about your business expertise if you didn't know what was going on in your departments?
I'm going to come to that question in just a second. We have seen pressure from Time Magazine, from the Washington Post, the New York Times, Rachel Maddow, MSNBC. It's kind of piling on now. Mm-hmm. Does the governor survive this without resigning or being fired?